Okay, welcome to the course of agent-based modeling. We are doing a simulation of disease propagation. So we have a word class now. Actually, we talk about this. So in each iteration, a pair of agent is selected and they make a handshake. After this handshake, we calculate the number of infected agents and we have a list for storing number of infected agents. It is called contagion. So this is a list. And we append new value after each iteration. So this is our word class, and we have seen that when we have 500 agents and we run the word for 100 times, actually number of infected people remains one. So it is one at the beginning, and after 100 iteration, it is still one. Why is that? So first of all, we have here all the agents are default value for infected is false. Just one agent is a infection. And after 100 iteration, it is still one. Okay. So we need to think about when a pair of agent is selected, what is the probability of choosing the only one infected agent? So here, if you think, probability of selected that infected agent is 1 minus probability of selected non-infected agents. So we have 500 agents and 499 of them is not infected. So this is the first agent. You choose a pair of agent is one agent and the other agent. One agent, probability of choosing non-infected is this value. Probability of selecting the other one, which is non-infected, is for among the rest of agents, 500 minus one, this much of them is non-infected. So this is probability of selecting non-infected agents. So if you make one minus, actually, this is the probability of taking infected agent in that pair. So if you calculate it, it is when you multiply this, actually they cancel out. So this is this number divided by 500. It is 2 divided by 500 or 4 divided by 1000. So here you see that at least 250 iteration is required to select one agent. When you actually we expect that on the average after 250 iterations we selected one infected agent among 500 non-infected agents. So this after 250 iterations, actually now you select infected agent and it can infect the other one, and the number of agent is increased by one. The number of infected agent increased by one. So 100 iteration is not enough. We require at least 250 iterations on the average. So this is what probability tells us, that 250 agent, 250 iteration is required to select that infected agent. So let's change this value to 250. Are we right? Let's see it. It seems like it doesn't work. Let's make it a little bit more. So statistically, this is what we expect. As you see, now we have more than one agent that is infected. So it means that in 300 pairs, we select two pairs that has one infected agent. Let's run this with 250 one more time. Now we have six agents here. Now this is what I expect. On the average, statistically, on the average, you choose a pair that's composed of one infected, one non-infected agent. Okay, let's continue. Okay, so if we increase the number of iterations here, as you see, we see that the number of infected people really grows. Does it grow to the infinity? Is there an upper bound? What do you think? Will it grow? If I make it, for example, 10,000, will it increase to the infinity? No, it will not. Why? We are bounded by the number of people in the population. So number of infected people cannot grow more than 500. So this is very logical. So let's run this. So the disease, so it will, what I expect, so it will grow like this one, and after that it will saturate, like here. Okay, as you see, it saturates. So 10,000 is too much. Let's make it 4,000, like that. So what we see is S-shaped curve. So this is called a sigmoid function in machine learning. So, and actually, for what we do here, there is a mathematical equation. So there are different types of modeling. One is equation-based modeling. You do it with differential equations. So in this course, we will not deal with differential equations, but this is another way of modeling, equation-based modeling. So there, for this method, for this disease propagation, so look at SIS model or SIR model. So these kinds of disease propagations, actually you see same here, you see same curve that is obtained by equation-based models. Okay, so this is the very first lecture on agent-based modeling, and we make a simulation of disease propagation. So so we make an introduction to agent-based modeling. We say that it is a bottom-up perspective. We talk about the importance of simulations. We see how to implement agent-based models with Python. So we see data manipulation, the difference between primitive data types and reference to objects. So if you change in data inside a reference to object, if this reference is shared among other agents, actually it will affect other agents. And we make a social simulation of infection. So in the coming lecture, we will see other social simulations. For example, this is disease propagation. So fashion is also like that. Idea or ideas propagate, fashion propagates. So, or when you buy a new product, actually, the other people see it from you and it gets more and more adopted by other people. Okay, we will see that kinds of simulation in the coming weeks, and later we will start to use these agent-based models for engineering problems like genetic algorithms, ant colony optimization, and neural networks. So that's it for today. Thank you for listening.